In this example, we are required to find the current in 6 ohm resistance and a potential difference across each cell in the circuit shown in figure. Here, there are 6 cells, all are identical with EMF 3 volt and internal resistance 4 ohm. Now, here we can write or we can simply replace the whole grid with a single equivalent EMF and equivalent internal resistance. If we use the concept of battery grid, you can write using battery grid concept. Here you can see there are 2 cells connected in series combination, then N can be taken as 2. And there are 3 rows connected. So, 3 rows connected in parallel, so M we can take as 3. Now, in this situation, we know that equivalent EMF in battery grid is NE. So, it will be equals to 2 into individual batteries of 3 volts. So, that will be 6 volt. And equivalent internal resistance for the battery grid we write as NR by M. So, in this situation, it will be 2R by 3. Here, R is 4 ohms. So, this will be 8 by 3 ohms. That means the whole circuit we can reduce to a single battery with an internal resistance. And the 6 ohm resistance can be connected across this group where the battery EMF is 6 volt and the internal resistance is 8 by 3 ohms. Now, the current flowing through the 6 ohm resistance can be directly calculated as the 6 volt EMF connected across 6 and 8 by 3 in series. So, this can be written as 6 upon 6 plus 8 by 3. On simplifying here, you will get 6 multiplied by 3. It will be 18 divided by, it will be 18 plus 8, that will be 24. This will be 26. So, the result will be 9 by 13 ampere, that is the current flowing through the 6 ohm resistance. Now, in this situation, this is one answer to our problem. We are required to find the current in 6 ohm resistance. We talk about the potential difference across each cell. As each cell is supplying some current, here we can say it will be written as E minus IR, where if a current I is flowing in this branch, that is 6 ohm, in this situation we can see that this current will be divided in 3 branches equally. So, this can be written as I by 3, I by 3 and I by 3 through each branch it is flowing. So, small I am taking as the current in any branch of the circuit, then it can be taken as the current supplied by each cell. So, the potential difference across each cell we can write as E minus IR, then E will be 3 minus this current will be I by 3, that will be 3 by 13. So, this will be 3 by 13 multiplied by 4. So, on simplifying, we are getting 3 minus 12 by 13. So, this will be 27 by 13 volt. That will be the potential difference across each cell in the circuit as all are connected in identical manner. And all are supplying the same current I by 3, which is 3 by 13 ampere. So, this will be another answer to this problem.